Hey there, Court, with you. Just thought I'd come chat a little while about some of the interesting things I've been finding. Not only about Oak Island, but Rennes le Chateau and Shugborough Hall and all these places that seem to be associated with each other through a thread of families and different historical events and monies or large amounts of gold that were lost in time of war. Now, in the past, I and a lot of other people have speculated how Rennes le Chateau and Shugborough Hall are connected together, and then possibly how Shugborough Hall and Oak Island may be connected together. And as I looked into this over the years now, it's been a few years that I've been looking at these common family connections to these treasure stories that of interest that we see at Rennes le Chateau, for instance, the story of Father Saunier finding parchments in the woodwork in the Mary Magdalene Chapel there that suggested that a work of Poussin and another of Teniers, the famous artist, were involved in the mystery. This was written on the parchment as kind of a clue. And then shortly after this parchment was found, Father Saunier makes a trip to Paris to visit Saint Sulpice, which is a collegiate cathedral or group of Catholic priests that's like a university somewhat. And then he was said by some sources to have returned to Rennes le Chateau with prints of the Teniers painting of Saint Anthony and the Poussin painting The Shepherds of Arcadia. So what is interesting about that is years before the time of Father Saunier, or whenever he found these parchments, that both of those paintings are part of the story of Shugborough Hall in England, which is famous for the Shepherd's Monument that includes a bas-relief mirror image of the Poussin painting Shepherds of Arcadia. And then it became obvious as well that the later Thomas Anson's wife was an accomplished painter, and she was known to copy famous classic paintings, and she had copied the Teniers painting as well. So the two paintings that are suggested in the parchments of Rennes le Chateau that Father Saunier found mention those same two paintings. So that's an odd connection of, you know, some consequence, but also obviously both paintings are very popular to people who like classic art, so it's not that out of the realm of possibility that both paintings could just simply be part of the natural story of both places. But another, that this kind of links to another strange part of the Rennes le Chateau story that a lot of people have mentioned before, about a man named Auguste Labouisse-Rochefort, who wrote a book called Voyage à Rennes les Bains in about 1832. And in this book, he describes various different treasures that are possibly in the area, including the temple treasure he makes allusions to that was sacked from the Temple of Peace of Rome and was possibly brought to the region of Septimania that was ruled by Alaric and Hof Ataulf, one of his commanders that had an affair with Galla Placidia, the Roman Augusta. So after they sacked the Temple of Rome, many of the theories say that Alaric took the treasure with him to Cosenza, Italy, where he passed away and had a tomb built in the middle of a river in which the river was changed course. And then he was entombed with the treasure is one of the major theories, because he died not long after the Temple of Peace of Rome was sacked at that time. But the other theory is that the temple treasure was brought to the region around Rennes le Chateau and Carcassonne. So this is one of the treasures that is kind of referred to in the whole mythology. There's a lot of different reasons treasures could be hidden in that area. The region was once part of Catalonia, and the Spanish gold trade had lots of shipments of gold coming through that area on their way to points east during the time the Spanish ruled Mexico, Central America, and South America. So that's of interest. If there's an actual treasure there, it could be from many different sources. But what is interesting is when I was researching another project I'm working on about the Montgomery Monument at St. Paul's Chapel in New York City, I ran across a reference that associated the Duc de Choiseul of Versailles, or of the administration of Louis XV and Louis XVI, as having been associated with a man named Pierre Hubert Anson. So, of course, I thought that was strange. Here's the Anson name of Shugborough Hall coming up in the form of a Frenchman who was part of the Assembly Nationale before the French Revolution, as was Louis-Alexandre Rochefort, another person who I've spoken of in relation to the Oak Island story, as he was the son of the Duc d'Anville, who lost his life in Nova Scotia during the d'Anville expedition, which also accounted for a possible large amount of lost gold that could be part of the Oak Island story. So finding Pierre Hubert Anson was kind of bizarre, and I, you know, could make no connection to the Anson family via looking into genealogy of both places. Pierre Hubert Anson may have been part of the Janssen family, which is I apostrophe Anson. That also may be related to the Anson family, possibly, though there is no record of that. The Anson family genealogy ends a few generations before Shugborough Hall was built, with no further information available about how far back that goes. So the entire Anson family could be related to the Janssen family, is how that's pronounced, I apostrophe Anson. So as I began to word search, of course, for Pierre Hubert Anson, I ran across an autograph site that was selling an autograph of Pierre Hubert Anson in a letter written to his friend Auguste Labouisse-Rochefort, who had written the book Voyage à Rennes le Chateau. So then I undertook a survey of Mr. Rochefort's other publications, and sure as heck, in there was an elegy to his friend Pierre Hubert Anson, in which he states that Pierre Hubert Anson is a member of the Anson family of Admiral Anson of Shugborough Hall. So that was quite a find. And, you know, logically, this makes no sense at all, because there's no records of an Anson being in France. There are records of the Janssen family that I mentioned before, being some of them being born in France, with one even being born in the Louvre Museum, and another being born in Montpellier in southern France along the coast, not far from Rennes le Chateau. So I don't know if it's true or not that Pierre Anson is related to the Anson family, but for some reason here now we have a man who wrote a book about a treasure near Rennes le Chateau in Labouisse-Rochefort, who even writes in his book about a treasure on Mont Blanchefort, where Chateau Blanchefort is, which is one of the tips of the star in the landscape described by Henry Lincoln as part of the Rennes le Chateau story, that at Chateau Blanchefort, or Mont Blanchefort, as he describes it, there was a treasure guarded by the devil. And this, of course, refers to the baptismal font in the Rennes le Chateau chapel of Asmodeus, who is a demon-like figure. It's an odd choice, of course, for a baptismal font to include the devil or a demon such as that as part of the church. So that may tie to that local piece of folklore that Labouisse-Rochefort is telling us about, with the devil guarding a treasure, and this may be the whole entire impetus for the later story of Father Saunier, whether this was a treasure that came from other sources that were more modern or not, that this story was somehow referenced to in the story of Rennes le Chateau. Now, interestingly, I did run across a tidbit that said there was another baptismal font that also used Asmodeus in the town where Rochefort was from in Montreal, France, which isn't too far to the northwest of Rennes le Chateau either. It's about 18 miles away. So that's very interesting, and this kind of instills the influence of Labouisse-Rochefort into the whole mystery in a larger way, in that he is suggesting that this Pierre Hubert Anson is a member of the Anson family of Shugborough Hall. So that's kind of an amazing connection between two places that a lot of people have speculated are related to each other, in which the Arcadian theme has been introduced into both places, including Shugborough Hall at the Shepherd's Monument, and then the mention of the same painting by Poussin in the Rennes le Chateau story as part of the parchments that Father Saunier found. So this is terribly, you know, new news here that kind of exposes a different facet of both stories. Now, even if Rochefort is claiming that Anson is a member of the Anson family of Shugborough Hall, may have been a ploy of some kind in order to make these connections, so we don't know. That's kind of a missing part of the whole thing, that I think I'm the first one who has noticed that Pierre Hubert Anson was written of by Rochefort in another one of his books. And it's interesting, in the elegy he describes Pierre Hubert Anson as a royalist at the time of the revolution just before. He was a part of the Assembly Nationale, which was an attempt to kind of start a constitutional monarchy in France that was similar to what we see in England at about the same time and earlier, that of course became the enemies of the revolution later, even though a lot of these people were in favor of a form of representative government, that they became persecuted during the Reign of Terror associated with the French Revolution. And both Anson and Rochefort, it is said, were hidden by Jesuit interests during that time, and it ended up surviving with Pierre Hubert Anson passing away in about 1810, and Rochefort, who was a little bit younger, living long past that. But what is also of great interest here is the fact that Auguste Labouisse-Rochefort was a member of the Pontifical Academy of Arcadia, which is an artist guild associated with the Vatican. And this artist guild was begun by Queen Christina of Sweden, who converted to Catholicism and abdicated her crown and moved to Rome. And she started a kind of artist guild at that time that even included Nicolas Poussin, who painted the Shepherds of Arcadia. And by about 1690, this group would come to be known as the Academia degli Dei Arcadia, which still exists today. And they were known to meet at interesting places like a sacred grove on the Capitoline Hill of Rome. That this artist guild was kind of a response to the many artist guilds of France and other places that had a huge impact on political issues and social issues via the influence of the artists and writers involved. So it's terribly interesting that Rochefort was a member of the Academy of Arcadia. Some sources also list him as being a member of the legendary Priory of Zion as well, who many people dispute is an actual organization. Other people actually do believe that the Priory of Zion existed, and there are some historical precedents for that, But I kind of tend towards the fact that it was not an actual group, that later in history some people may have picked up on that concept and created a similar organization. But it is very similar when you break that down to the Academy of Arcadia, but the Priory of Zion goes back farther in history, according, you know, to the records that have been presented of the membership and things like that. So here we have a whole new connection to Rennes le Chateau and Shugborough Hall. And there are a lot of ways in which Shugborough Hall also relates to the Oak Island mystery via this kind of organization that they had in England of naval intelligence services, or intelligence services on a national level as a whole, which a lot of people neglect to factor in to stories like Oak Island, Shugborough Hall, or Rennes le Chateau. But, you know, as a matter of fact, intelligence gathering and operations have been part of the, you know, landscape of history ever since there were monarchies or one group of people trying to control another group, that these kind of skullduggerous stories may have been made up to cover up certain embarrassing parts of narratives like Oak Island or other places. But surrounding Admiral Anson of Shugborough Hall and Thomas Anson, who is actually responsible for the Shepherd's Monument and the other follies at Rennes le Chateau, is what appears to be an intelligence service that was geared on gathering information about the coming and going of French fleets going to the Americas that often included large amounts of gold for payrolls, such as at Fortress Louisbourg, and even for the Danville expedition. In fact, at the second sacking of Louisbourg, the treasurer was a man named Jean Laborde, and he was also the treasurer of the Danville expedition. He was actually accused of misappropriating what would be worth about $150 million today. And this is very strange. Again, though there are no records of being related to a slightly later man named Alexander Laborde, is very curious, because Alexander Laborde had a association with members of the Anson family, and not to mention the fact that for a brief period of time he ended up owning the art collection of Queen Christina of Sweden, who had created the Academy of Arcadia of the Vatican. That also included several paintings by Nicolas Poussin. And Poussin has other paintings that refer to the theme of Arcadia as well. So the Shepherds of Arcadia painting may not be the only important Poussin to consider in this whole story. So it's just awfully amazing that that name too is involved and in association with the Anson family. There's records of them interacting via political meetings and things like that, or just socially. So we have this kind of whole new, you know, thread of information to follow out. There's very little information available about Pierre Hubert Anson, but I feel like if we can find out more about this man, that it may reveal something about all of these places and how they are related to each other together. So, my theory is that the theme of Arcadia relates to Oak Island via Philip Sidney, and not necessarily through Nicolas Poussin, who created a great icon of the theme of Arcadia, which had been popular since before the time of Christ. So Arcadia, in that way, from the poet Virgil, has been an influence on monarchies and symbolic toward the ancient regime, or how monarchies longed for a simpler time when they were in control of everything via a feudal society, and how these things began to collapse with the advent of representative governments and things like that, that Arcadia came to even more represent a hearkening back to a more peaceful time for those who were in power. So there's a lot more to that, and as many of you well know, There's a story in Philip Sidney's book Arcadia, published in 1580, that includes a money pit. The description of the money pit in the story is similar to the one we all know and love about Oak Island, even including a, quote, graven stone at the bottom, like the 90-foot stone. And so that entire story is interesting when we consider that after the book was published in 1580, in about 1620, the Baron of Nova Scotia, Sir William Alexander, amended Philip Sidney's book with a new chapter that even referred to Philip Sidney's heritage in The Black Knight. The chapter that's added by the Baron of Nova Scotia involves a black knight, and Philip Sidney's heritage also includes a family member that was the, quote, black knight. As I looked into that even further, that one of the courtiers of Charles I, whose last words were from Philip Sidney's book Arcadia before he was beheaded, was a member of the Alexander family who had married into the Herbert family of Philip Sidney's sister, the Countess of Pembroke, who the book Arcadia had been dedicated to. So there's definite connections even between the Alexander family of the Baron of Nova Scotia and the Herbert family of Mary Sidney Herbert, the Countess of Pembroke, the sister of Philip Sidney. And this is also of interest to Shakespeare lovers or mystery lovers, in that the two sons of the Countess of Pembroke, Philip and William Herbert, were the subjects of Ben Jonson's dedication of the first folio of Shakespeare. In fact, Philip Herbert was actually married to Susan de Vere, the daughter of the 17th Earl of Oxford, who many people suspect of having been involved in the production of the works of Shakespeare. So this is a very interesting kind of crossroads of all kinds of interesting, mysterious things that also distantly relate us to Shugborough Hall, Rennes le Chateau, and even Oak Island, according to many theories. And kind of one of the central families are the Herbert family in the middle of all this. I mean, we have Mary Sidney Herbert being friends with Dr. John Dee, a courtier of Elizabeth I. Mary Sidney and Philip Sidney's mother was married to the Dudley family. And this meant that Sir Robert Dudley, who many people speculate had an affair with Queen Elizabeth, and that Sir Francis Bacon was their son, would have been the aunt of Sir Francis Bacon, if that's true. And then Philip Sidney and Mary Sidney, the Countess of Pembroke, would have been Sir Francis Bacon's first cousins, if this were to be true. Now, there's no proof of that, but a lot of people do espouse that theory in the story of Sir Francis Bacon. But that, if nothing else, that's emblematic of showing you how Philip Sidney was right in the middle of a lot of different mysterious stories involving the works of Shakespeare, the value of the Arcadian theme on the part of French and English nobles, and more. So we even see, which I'll get into this more next time, Philip Sidney is actually related to Thomas Jefferson via Sir Francis Walsingham, the, quote, spy master of Queen Elizabeth. Walsingham's brother-in-law was Thomas Randolph, who was a direct forebear of Thomas Jefferson. Philip Sidney was the son-in-law of Sir Francis Walsingham. Another one of the people in the circle of Walsingham's spies is a man named Robert Beale. And I'm sure treasure lovers out there know what the Beale family name means in relation to the Beale treasure of Virginia. So there are some weird ways that these kind of premier treasure stories are related to each other. And this new Pierre Anson info in France kind of gives us a new link between Rennes le Chateau and then I've given you a little bit of background into these far-reaching things. So next time I'm going to come here and tell you about the mysteries of Virginia, including the Bruton Fault and the Beale Treasure, and tell you how they're related to the Randolph family of Thomas Jefferson. But for now, think about Pierre Hubert Anson, Rennes le Chateau, and Shugborough Hall. Thanks for being with me here this time. See you next time.